President Joe Biden was on 60 Minutes and he was asked a question about what the United States would be willing to do in order to defend Taiwan. I would like you to take a look at his response. It's quite astonishing.
What should Chinese President Xi know about your commitment to Taiwan?
We agree with what we signed on to a long time ago. And that there's a one China policy, and Taiwan makes their own judgments about their independence. We are not moving, we're not encouraging their being independent. We're not, that's their decision.
But would U.S. forces defend the island?
Yes, if in fact there was an unprecedented attack.
After our interview, a White House official told us U.S. policy has not changed. Officially, the U.S. will not say whether American forces would defend Taiwan. But the commander-in-chief had a view of his own.
So unlike Ukraine, to be clear, sir, U.S. forces, U.S. men and women, would defend Taiwan in the event of a Chinese invasion.
Yes.
That was absolutely incredible in maybe the worst way imaginable. So he goes on to essentially state that if the Chinese, led by Mr. Xi, were to enact some sort of, I'm sure what they would see as this unprovoked, rash, you know, ridiculous sort of scheme to go at Taiwan, this is of course the way that they're phrasing it, he would respond by enacting World War III and quite possibly bringing with it the decimation of us all, because that's what that would spell out. It's a war between two nuclear powers. I have no idea why at this point, having seen the capabilities, at least to some extent, of what nuclear weapons can do. Of course, this was at the hands of America, of the U.S., dropping those two nuclear bombs. We still have, you know, doubts or questions today about where a war between two nuclear armed powers would lead us. It's quite astonishing. But anyway, back to Mr. Biden. So he was asked the question, would U.S. forces defend Taiwan if invaded by China? And his answer was probably the most blatant he ever gave to such a question, which was yes. And I say probably the most blatant he's ever given to such a question, because he's actually been asked this before. And he's given more or less the same answer, but it just wasn't so out in the open. It was a bit more vague. And what I want to do quickly is just give you a couple of instances, actually several instances in the past leading up to this moment, where he has indeed done pretty much the same thing. And I also like to clarify before I proceed that the White House is echoing different rhetoric than what Biden is saying here. So every time he comes out and does this nonsense, saying that he'd spark a world war over Taiwan, which we'll hopefully get into in just a second, the White House comes out and says, well, no, that's not the White House's policy. The White House's policy remains what it is, which is essentially they just decline to comment. So the White House's policy on Taiwan is they don't want to talk about it. That's literally their policy. But Biden's policy is, I'm going to take us to the brink of catastrophe. He's ready to send U.S. men and women to die for a place that I don't even know what 98% of the American people can't point out on a map or know the history of. That's what he's willing to do. He's willing to risk all of our lives for what reason? Anyway, so let's get into past instances where he's done essentially the same thing. So back in May, Biden said yes when asked by the press if the U.S. would defend Taiwan militarily in the event of a Chinese invasion, adding, and I quote, "That's the commitment we made. Once again, we speak of this false commitment. There is no such commitment. He made no commitment." A White House official later stated that the president's comments did not reflect the change in U.S. policy. Once again, the White House's policy, of course, different from Biden, is to just not talk about it. At a CNN forum in October of last year, Biden responded in the affirmative when asked by an audience member if the U.S. would intervene to defend Taiwan, and said, yes, we have a commitment. Once again, there is no such commitment. When asked to clarify if he meant intervening in against an attack from China, again, the White House quickly clarified that there was no change in their policy, which again is to simply not talk about it. In an interview with ABC's George Stephanopoulos in August of last year, Biden implied that the U.S. would defend Taiwan as it would a NATO ally. Wow. Saying that the U.S. has kept every commitment, same with Taiwan, when asked if China might be emboldened to attack the island by the U.S. military withdrawal from Afghanistan. Again, a senior administration official told the press, our policy with regard to Taiwan has not changed, which again is to simply not to talk about it and answer questions regarding it. So what does this mean? Why is it that President Joe Biden, the commander-in-chief of the most heinous, destructive, largest, most powerful military in history, say that he's ready to spark a world war over Taiwan, and the White House is saying, well, that's not really our policy, and their policy is just simply to keep quiet about it. Is it that Joe Biden's brain has rotted so much to the point that he can't keep up with his own administration's policy, or is this something deeper? What exactly does this mean? We've been seeing over the past several years, actually, the United States, especially in recent times, have been ramping up tensions with China regarding Taiwan, and it's been happening at an astronomical rate. It's insane how quick this is occurring with the delegations of politicians from the United States going over Nancy Pelosi, one of the most ardent the weapons deals, sales that they're still making to Taiwan. Let's get into a little bit of what he had to say in that video. He talked about this commitment to Taiwan, and he brought up the One China policy. Well, you're not honoring the One China policy by continuing your current policy, Mr. Biden. You're just not. You know, sending politicians over to Taiwan, basically encouraging independence, which is what he said that he wasn't doing. Biden thinks that he's not encouraging independence, that the U.S., that Washington is not encouraging independence by sending politicians over to meet with separatists, by sending weapons, by doing ratifying weapons deals. I mean, it doesn't make any sense, or in fact, maybe it makes a lot of sense. He says that Taiwan should decide. All of this directly opposes what is contained in the One China policy, which the vast majority of the world sees to be extremely valid and legitimate, as well as China's grievances as pertaining to Taiwan. Pretty much the same with Russia's grievances with Ukraine, and it's a similarity between the two powers, that being Russia and China, in relation to the U.S. and the U.S.'s refusal to take them seriously and see their claims to these specific places as legitimate and come up with a compromise and deal with it in a diplomatic way. But no, they just want to ramp up tensions and threaten us all with war. That seems to be the policy, at the very least, of Mr. Biden, and the White House doesn't even want to speak of it. But this is incredible. This is the most out and open and honest he's ever been with this. Just saying, just blatantly, it won't be like Ukraine. We won't stage a proxy war, you know, with like we're doing with Russia, trying to weaken them. Of course, not if it's working. When it comes to China, though, and Taiwan, we're willing to sacrifice American soldiers and pretty much everything else that would come with that. In conclusion here, just to wrap this up, because of course you will have those that will say, you know, the State Department bullshit, they'll echo that same kind of nonsense. Oh, well, of course, they're just defending Taiwan. It's always this defense. Everything Washington does, no matter how ridiculous it is, it's characterized as defense. They're defending a part of China. And by the way, China's reintegration policy as it pertains to Taiwan was something that was going to happen over the course of decades. I think it was by like 2056 or something. Don't quote me on that. They wanted Taiwan to be reintegrated back into China officially, so to speak. But now, of course, they're trying to speed things up because of U.S. policy. But anyway, so we're supposed to believe that The country that has this statistic to be applied to them, that I'm going to read to you in a second, is doing all of this for defense. The U.S. military launched 469 foreign interventions since 1798, including 251 since the end of the first Cold War in 1991, according to official Congressional Research Service data. So this is from congressional researchers, researchers themselves coming out with this data. Now, this is according to a report by the Congressional Research Service, a U.S. government institution that compiles information on behalf of Congress. That's absolutely outstanding. And of course, it leaves out certain things. This is from the report, but this does not include covert actions or numerous occurrences in which U.S. forces have been stationed abroad since World War II in occupation forces or for participation in mutual security organizations, base agreements, or routine military assistance or training operations. They also don't include the deployment of U.S. military forces against indigenous people, the ethnic cleansing, and all the rest of it. But anyway, you get the picture. They want us to believe that the state that has this statistic applied to it, the one that I just read to you, the one that was involved in all these military operations, covert, specialized operations, the overthrowing of so many governments, the policies where they want to encircle powers that stand to suppress them economically and in many other different ways, that they, everything they do is for defense, and it's to uphold the sovereignty and the democracy of whatever it is that they're quote-unquote protecting.